So all of the fish heads that we got, it was just the fillet that was taken off.
Yeah, yeah.
And like what, 70% of the fish is still around.
Yeah, yeah.
But people buy the fillets in the supermarket and it's so disconnected from what the actual animal is or the fish. And I think people are really grossed out about the head because you're literally looking at the face.
Tuesday to Friday, we pick up from one of fisheries. We pick up around 400 kilos a day from them, so over a ton a week. To date, we've diverted around over 113,000 kgs of fish. And then we come back. People will be waiting to pick up their offcuts. Some bring big bins to feed their communities, and then we distribute out to the families, and then that's pretty much our day done.
Today we're going to be making Singaporean fish head bihun noodle soup.
What we have here is a already filleted snapper. So this snapper that we pick up are from Moana Fisheries. So first, we separate the wing from the frame. I actually get right under. We already got the head. Pull them out. Boom.
What do you use the entrails for?
The guts, we are trialing a fish emulsion, which is a type of fertilizer for our garden. So,
so you use every single
part of the fish we are using today. Yeah. You sort of want to get in there, and I sort of grab like a underneath here. So then I'm moving the fish towards the blade.
Right.
And then just do a twist motion. Once that main bit is off, pull and twist.
And that's the wing. That's
the wing here. So we've got the head now, it's all fresh.
Cool.
And then with the wing, what we do is we just separate it open, and then we just grab the throat. Bang. So we got guts for fish emulsion, fresh wing, head. Boom!
Mean. It's going to be delicious. So we're going to make the base for the soup stock, and we're going to fry all of the fish heads until they're really nice and golden brown, and it will give the stock heaps of flavour. And what makes the soup really special is that it is really creamy and it's really milky, and so when you fry the fish heads first, then it helps emulsify the stock later. And then we fry the aromatics until it smells so, so good. Then we add it all into a stock pot and boil it. Boil it for about 30 minutes until it's really fragrant, milky, and creamy.
Ah! Oh, geez, my name is Mr. Burns. Teamwork.
Mm.
My grandpa used to make fish heads when I was little, but I didn't really like it. I didn't like the smell. I didn't like the taste or anything about fish heads until this project came up around rescuing the fish and then actually trying it.
And now you love them.
And I love it, man. I love it so much. The eyes mainly.
What do you like about the eyes?
The eyes, the texture of it.
Mm-hmm. So like the eye is really gelatinous and you kind of suck it
and
spit it out. I like it. It's fun.
Our ancestors, you know, always used to fish for fish.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like in this day and age, we're catching way too much fish, which is needed, you know. Back in the days, we used to follow the maramataka, which is the moon cycle, around when to go out fishing. If this tree is blossoming, then that's a good time for us to go fishing. So I think our tupuna, or our ancestors, were quite smart around how they fish, how they collect their food, how they grow their food. I feel like that's been lost through convenience.
Mm-hmm.
Now that we've got people that fillet it, now that we've got people that package it, I feel like we're just buying it and consuming it. So I feel like it's just been, can you say colonized? In a way, like, man.
You touched on a really good point about the disconnect between us and where our food comes from also.
Yeah, yeah.
So all of the fish heads that we got, it was just the fillet that was taken off.
Yeah, yeah.
And like, what, 70% of the fish is still around.
Yeah, yeah.
But people buy the fillets in the supermarket and it's so disconnected from what the actual animal is, or the fish. And I think people are really grossed out about the head because you're literally looking at the face. And I think the way that we package up meat, the way that we package up fish, it's so we don't have that connection between where it's from and how we consume it. And I think when we make those links, then like have our relationships with the sea, with the land, with the animals is more respectful, and we can honor that. Life as opposed to just, you know, this like plastic shrink wrap thing that you get and it's disposable and you just throw it away.
And that's not having full respect for the fishy.
Yeah.
We respect the fish by, you know, utilizing the whole thing, and I feel like that's what we're missing.
For sure.
A bit of respect, man.
Sure.
Put some respect on that meme.
That's why I was really inspired by your fish emulsion too.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So that even the guts that are full of these amazing enzymes make the garden so abundant, so fruitful. Mm. When I was growing up, I grew up here and there was a lot of racism, I think, especially for Asians. Mm. I think there is also a lot of internalized racism after that, being told that actually your food is really disgusting, even if it's dumplings or fried rice that people really love now and they all go to Dom Road to eat. But back in the day, and it wasn't even that long ago, I felt so ashamed to bring anything that wasn't a white bread sandwich or like an apple or an LCM bar. Do you remember those? And I realized that the food that my mum was packing for me, it's nutritious, it was delicious, it was made with so much care, but it wasn't accepted. So for years I didn't want to eat fish heads, I didn't want to eat anything yucky because it would be seen as gross. And I would be seen as gross.
Yeah.
But so us eating this is just, we're reclaiming it.
Beautiful.